The San Marcos Greenbelt Alliance needs support from local volunteers like you to help monitor and preserve the green spaces for our community and future generations. Visit www.smgreenbelt.org to search all possible volunteer opportunities and how to get involved. Some volunteer activities consist of picking up litter to maintain the beautification of the green spaces, helping build and repair bridges to sustain the safety and reliability of their structure, clearing trails of debris from wind damage and storms helps maintain safety for nature enthusiasts, and marking trails to guide hikers in the right direction. So visit the San Marcos Greenbelt Alliance website to find a full listing of volunteer opportunities, and let's get to work.
There's a new debate about the Student Center and staying open on weekends. Thanks for watching Bobcat Update. I'm Matthew Weibel.
And I'm Rachel Nelson. We'll also tell you what to do if you missed today's campus flu shot clinic. Students are used to seeing the faces of Bill Cosby, Bob Marley, and Jimi Hendrix on campus. Stenciled graffitis with a consistent style is a common sight at Texas State. Although the University Police Department has not been able to pinpoint a culprit, investigators believe the stencils could be made using supplies from the art building. When discovered, workers cover up or blast away the paint using high-power washers. UPD Sergeant Brian Carpenter said vandalism that occurs on school property carries a higher penalty than off-campus offenses. Anyone with information should contact the UPD.
The push to impeach the Chief Justice of the Associated Student Government at Texas State is over. Michael Guzman came under fire for his opinion pieces in the University Star that focused on hippies and liberals, to name a few groups. A petition filed this month claimed Guzman violated the Code of Ethics for discrimination by writing those opinion pieces. But at a meeting this past Monday, the ASG Disciplinary Committee ruled the wording in the Constitution is too ambiguous and there were no grounds for Guzman to be impeached.
Early voting has started in San Marcos. Jessica Garcia has more in this Bobcat update.
Early voting began this Monday morning for midterm elections. Here in San Marcos, people came out to vote for their city mayor and city council members, place 1, 2, and 6.
If you don't have early voting, I think if everybody that votes comes out on the actual voting day, the lines may be too long and you may actually discourage people from coming and vote.
Until Friday, October 29th, there are two locations in the city where you can vote. Hays County registered voters can go to the San Marcos Public Library or the Hays County Elections Office to cast their ballots.
Well, early voting is very important. I ran for mayor 2 years ago and I lost the election. It was the presidential election. I really saw that my deficiency there was came out clearly in early voting.
San Marcos voters will be choosing a new mayor and positions on the city council. Running for mayor are John Tomaitis and Daniel Guerrero. And for city council place 1 are Kim Porterfield and Dave Newman.
Even if you don't vote for me, just get out and vote. It's what makes America the land of the free, and we need to keep it that way. Voting is the means to perpetuate that.
City Council Place 2 candidates are Toby Hooper and Jude Prather. For City Council Place 6, candidates are Shane Scott and Rodney Van Oudkirk. County, state, and national elections will be decided as well.
If everybody should vote, whether you're a Democrat or a Republican, whatever you are, I think everybody should, because it's too easy for people that after the government is in, then they start complaining. But they didn't do anything about it to participate in it.
Texas State University will host early voting on October 28th and 29th in the LBJ Student Center. For Bobcat Update, I'm Jessica Garcia.
Residents of San Marcos are being asked to help pay for an expansion of the Austin Community College taxing district. ACC is hoping to expand beyond Travis County, and San Marcos is one of 5 communities where annexation is on the ballot this year. If approved, area residents would pay more in taxes, but students would benefit by having more programs and services at a lower cost. Tuition would drop to about $42 per credit hour, compared with the out-of-district cost of $150 per hour. If the proposition is approved, ACC will establish a permanent campus in Hays County in 2013.
Three of his challengers showed up, but the governor himself took a pass last night when the Texas gubernatorial candidates debated. Democrat Bill White, Libertarian Kathy Glass, and Green Party nominee Deb Shapto took turns criticizing Governor Rick Perry's leadership. The one-hour debate was sponsored by the Austin American-Statesman and other media organizations. Governor Perry declined the offer to debate because White, his Democratic challenger, had not released his income tax returns. His challengers criticized Perry's stance on education, spending, and border security.
With only Harris and Jones dining halls open on the weekends, ASG President Mel Ferrari is pushing to expand at the LBJ Student Center weekend hours. The University Star reports that the Food Services Committee will meet to discuss the benefits of opening the Student Center on weekends. Ferrari plans to coordinate events like showcasing local bands or host movie nights in the teaching theater to bring students to the Student Center on the weekends. If implemented, the change in hours would not take effect until fall 2011.
It's time of year again, and students need to think about getting their annual flu shot. The biggest flu outreach event for Texas State was held today in the ballroom of the LBJ Student Center. From 10 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon, students, faculty, and staff were able to freely walk in and get their seasonal flu shot. Nurse Supervisor Gina Burns says that it is recommended for everyone to get a flu shot this year. If students were unable to attend the flu outreach, they should make an appointment with the Student Health Center as soon as possible. The San Marcos Fire Department is doing its part to raise money to fight breast cancer. In this Bobcat update, Mandy Garcia tells us about the Pink Heels charity event.
Firefighters, police officers, and local volunteers brought the Pink Heels Tour to San Marcos Embassy Suites on Saturday, promoting love and support during Breast Cancer Awareness Month. The nationwide tour travels with pink fire trucks for 57 days, making stops in about 100 cities. Founder Dave Graybill started the nonprofit organization to raise funds for research and treatment for all life-threatening diseases.
All we're doing is inspiring communities to celebrate those organizations and give the money to them. We don't take any money. We do this for free.
The event was filled with live music and raffles. Cancer survivors shared stories and signed the pink trucks. Family and friends honored their loved ones who have been affected by disease. Tour General Manager Michelle Carswell enjoys promoting local charities with Pink Heels.
And so it really allows us the opportunity to get firsthand involved in our community, you know, directly and indirectly. And we do have the solace of knowing that we make a very firm impact.
This is the second time the tour has stopped in San Marcos. Carswell says she hopes the event will be even bigger next year.
The Pink Heels Tour has been traveling for 57 days and have already raised over $200,000 for the cause. For Bobcat Update, I'm Mandy Garcia.
The U.S. Supreme Court is considering a case involving a Texas death row inmate who is attempting to use civil rights law to access DNA evidence that could prove his innocence in a triple murder. Texas inmate Henry Skinner is asking that civil rights law be used to force the state to examine DNA evidence left at the scene of the crime. Skinner was convicted and sentenced to death for the 1993 slayings of his girlfriend and her two adult sons. The Supreme Court agreed to hear Skinner's case after granting him a stay last March. A decision may come as late as next year.
Houston police say it's a case of road rage that led to murder. Police are looking for two armed men who shot at another driver after a confrontation over being cut off in traffic. The man who was cut off honked his horn and gave chase to the other vehicle. The occupants of the other vehicle then opened fire, shooting as many as 8 shots, one of which killed the driver who was giving chase. The man's SUV then plowed into an apartment complex and into the bedroom of another man who narrowly escaped with his life. No arrests have yet been made.
Homecoming week is underway at Texas State.
We'll have a rundown of all the events next on Bobcat Update.
What's the matter, Billy? Thinking about the future getting you down?
Feeling uncertain of what's to come after you graduate? Well, I've got a real keen idea for you. Conveniently located on the 5th floor of the LBJ Student Center. Career Services is the bee's knees, leading Texas State students into the future. Career Services' friendly staff will guide you through all stages of your career development and progression. Their services include job search strategies and finding internships and job shadows. Their career library offers a wide variety of current books to help land you in the right career that suits you best. Their friendly staff offers career counseling and mock interviews, as well as resume and cover letter critique. So, what do you say, Billy? The future's starting to look a little brighter?
It was like a horror show. That's how a witness described the shooting massacre at Fort Hood almost a year ago. A hearing is underway to determine if the case against alleged shooter Nidal Hassan will proceed. Hassan is accused of killing 13 people and injuring dozens at a crowded Army Medical Processing Center. Hassan faces a possible death penalty if the case proceeds to a court-martial. The hearing is scheduled to last several weeks, well past the November 5th anniversary of the shootings. Witnesses yesterday described the panic and confusion during the massacre.
A Dallas dad says he's been booted from his son's Cub Scout troop because he is gay. Now, John Langbert wants to see some changes to the long-standing policy of rejecting leaders who are gay or atheist. Langbert says he was told not to wear the Cub Scout uniform anymore while attending functions with his 9-year-old son. Langbert is taking the matter to court, saying he believes the Boy Scouts should not be allowed to meet in public schools. He argues that discriminatory practices, like the one he's encountered, should not be allowed on public tax-supported property.
Students in the Zemarkis School District no longer have random UIL drug testing to hold them accountable. According to the San Marcos Daily Record, district trustees have ended the tests, citing both funding concerns and the fact that only a handful of students received true positive tests since 2004. Board President Kathy Hansen said it was a no-brainer to suspend the program due to lack of federal funding. Hansen said that if the situation changes, the board could always look to reinstate the program.
A new commission to support the Texas State Musical Theater Program has been donated for the creation of new plays. Adam Holloway has more in this Bobcat update.
2 years after donating $8 million to the theater department to develop a new performing arts center, Patty Strickle Harrison of the PSH Foundation of Wimberley will commission two new plays every 3 years. The donation should bring well-established Broadway writers and composers to Texas State.
Tony and Grammy Award nominee Andrew Lippa is the first recipient of the commission. Department Chair Dr. John Fleming predicts the partnership will greatly help the theater department.
The idea of being in on the ground floor as a work is being developed, that's one way you actually, it's a skill you need to learn because that's a good way to get jobs in the industry and a way to get seen and known.
The first original play written for Texas State should be finished by 2014 and will be presented in the new Performing Arts Center, which will replace Falls Dormitory. Theater major Catherine Gretzner is excited about the new productions.
I just think it's exciting that we have such a big name writer and composer coming to help out the Texas State Department. It's going to be really awesome.
The next commission will be announced early next year. Andrew Lippa will continue to write productions for the theater, teach classes, and present workshops throughout his residency. For Bobcat Update, I'm Adam Holloway.
One of TV's best-known and loved dads has died. Actor Tom Bosley died early Tuesday at a hospital in Palm Springs, California. His family says he died of heart failure. Bosley played Mr. Cunningham on the long-running 70s and 80s sitcom, Happy Days. His co-star Henry Winkler, who played the Fonz, told the Los Angeles radio station he's shocked and saddened. Winkler's character referred to him on the show as Mr. C. In 2004, TV Guide ranked Mr. C as number 9 on its list of the 50 greatest TV dads of all time. Bosley was 83.
Homecoming week is in full swing, and the Texas State volleyball team will face UT Arlington at 6:30 tonight at Strahan Coliseum. Also in celebration of Homecoming week, the Student Association of Campus Activities will host a talent show at 7 o'clock at Evans Auditorium. Tomorrow night at 6, there will be a spirit rally at the LBJ Amphitheater. The Bobcat football team will play the Northwestern State Demons at 3 in the afternoon Saturday at Bobcat Stadium. The homecoming king and queen will be presented at halftime.
Speaking of Bobcat football, the team is once again looking to get the season back on track.
We'll have that story coming up next in sports.
The San Marcos Activity Center has been serving the San Marcos community for over 12 years.
Their facilities include 2 indoor basketball courts,
aerobics rooms,
indoor swimming pool,
racquetball courts,
youth sports,
a weight training room, and much more. Whether you want to master the art of yoga, strengthen your core, or are a senior looking to regain the strength of your youth, there is a fitness class to fit everyone's needs at the San Marcos Activity Center.
For more information, call 512-393-8280 or visit the website.
The San Marcos Activity Center is the place for San Marcos residents to get fit and have some fun. So come by today and visit the center of it all.
Hi, I'm Will McGinnis with sports. The Texas Rangers are trying to punch a ticket to the World Series today. Last night it was Game 4 against the Yankees in the Bronx. Josh Hamilton doing what he does best here as he hits a solo shot in the top of the 7th inning, giving the Rangers a 6-3 lead. More of the same coming in the top of the 9th, as here Hamilton again saying, "I'm not done yet." He's going to get his second home run of the game, giving the lead to the Rangers at 7-3. The Rangers would go on to win the game 10-3, giving owner Nolan Ryan a good reason to smile there in New York. The teams are back at it right now. Game 5 started at 2:30 this afternoon. The Rangers are trailing in the 5th inning, 5-0. On the other side of the pennant race, the San Francisco Giants grabbed an edge in the 7-game series as they beat the Phillies last night 3-0. Matt Cain outdueled Cole Hamels, allowing no runs on 3 hits before leaving in the 8th. This was the third straight quality pitching matchup in as many games for the NLCS, as Giants starters have yet to allow an unearned run in 22 2/3 innings at home this postseason. Tonight's Game 4 matchup features Joe Blanton and Madison Bumgarner. Game time tonight, 7 o'clock on Fox. Texas State fans showed up last Saturday wearing pink to support breast cancer awareness as the Bobcat football team returned home to face Nicholls State. Here in the first quarter, Nicholls State able to take the lead on that Quentin Castone run from 8 yards. The Bobcats able to intercept a pass. And later in the second, DeMarcus Griggs hit here on a 44-yard touchdown pass from Tyler Arndt. In the third, trying to take the lead, the Bobcats field goal here blocked and taken all the way to the house by the Colonels. They take the lead here, but in the fourth, aren't able to hook up with Darren Dillard and DeMarcus Griggs yet again to take the lead. Last play of regulation here, the Nicholls State Colonels able to tie it up and force 4 overtimes. Here they get the final play of the game as they get their 2-point conversion, winning 47-45. The Bobcats are 0-2 in Southland Conference play and face Northwestern State this Saturday at 3 o'clock for the homecoming game. Another close game this weekend is the Minnesota Vikings beat the Dallas Cowboys 24-21 on Sunday. Cowboys head coach Wade Phillips today said he is considering inviting referees to the team's practices to try and correct a league-leading 30 offensive penalties. The boys will try and break this trend against the New York Giants on Monday Night Football. Meanwhile, the Houston Texans rallied to beat the Kansas City Chiefs 35-31. AFC Offensive Player of the Week Matt Schaub threw for over 300 yards and 2 scores, as Houston is now 4-2 on the year, headed into their bye week. John High is a familiar face on Austin television. He's a sports anchor and reporter for the Fox affiliate. What you might not know is John's strong link with Texas State University. Tommy Levere tells us more in this Bobcat update.
John High loves sports. You're apt to see him covering games throughout the Hill Country. For several years, he's been a go-to guy as part of the sports reporting team at Fox 7 in Austin. In the early 90s, John was part of another sports team, the football team here at Texas State, then known as Southwest Texas State University. He was quarterback, and he was a student. When not on the field, High spent a lot of time in Old Main, where he was working on his degree in mass communication. He was learning how to be a television broadcaster.
Gang violence is on the rise, and instead of parents worrying about their children learning at school, they now have to worry about their child's safety. Reporting for Channel 19 News, I'm John High.
Dr. Lori Fluker says she remembers John's enthusiasm.
John is someone who always yearned and sought for more knowledge than what we always just standardly gave in the classroom. So, you know, just a pleasant opportunity to have a student like that.
After graduation, John fulfilled his dream of being a sports broadcaster. He's met many of the up-and-comers in sports as he once was, and he's met the legends. He'll never forget his encounter as a player against Michael Strahan, who would later become an NFL All-Pro defensive end.
I made him look pretty bad when he was in college when they played against us. I threw for 2 touchdowns and ran for 2 as well. I was the Southland Player of the Week that week against him, so that was probably the best moment.
Today, as a broadcaster, he is able to return to the campus to show his Bobcat pride. For Bobcat Update, I'm Tommy Levere.
Well, I bet that story's pretty encouraging for you, right, Will?
Yeah, you know, I hope the folks at the job fair tomorrow were keeping a close eye on me today.
I know, I'll be looking to get my foot in the door. Well, that's it for this edition of Bobcat Update. Thanks for watching.
We'll be back tomorrow afternoon at 4:30. See you then.